Someone who knew him, Janine Giovanni, is the Middle East editor of Newsweek magazine, a former friend of Stephen Sotloff and colleague. She's in Paris, France tonight, and she joins me. Let me ask you about what did he say about the risks of reporting from Syria? He knew what they were, clearly.
He wrote me a rather chilling message, one of the last ones I got, which was basically about how we're all very naive. And he said that he was still going out to take pictures or to take film footage on his camera, on his phone, while bombs were dropping, which, of course, you shouldn't be doing. You should be inside hiding. But he said it was a kind of the infallibility of journalists, that we believe we're not going to get hurt, we're not going to get killed, we're not going to get kidnapped. He was very young. He was only 31, and he was starting out in his career. But at the same time, he was very clever. He was very philosophical. He was aware of the risks. One thing he had told me, which was, again, rather chilling, was that he was concerned that he had been on some kind of a list. And this was about the time that ISIS first started showing up, mm-hmm. And were taking over various checkpoints that had been manned before by the Syrian rebels. And he felt that he had angered some of the rebels, he didn't know which ones, by taking footage of a hospital in Aleppo that had been bombed. And he was very concerned about this. But he still went back, and he wanted to work on projects that were long-term, that were very profound and deep-reaching. He wanted to work with me on a project that I couldn't actually work with him, which was about rape inside Syria. Mm-hmm. He wanted to really get his teeth into the story. And he kept going back. He had the same fear that all of us had working in Syria, the paranoia, the fear, the uncertainty, but yet the kind of desire to tell this story, because in a sense, what ISIS are trying to do now is to frighten us, to scare not only us, but the civilian population, mm-hmm. so that there will be no reporting of what they're doing. There will be no stories being told of how the people right. are living.
Janine, let me just jump in here. We understand, and Luke, you're saying this is a statement from the Sotloff family, is that correct? The family spokesperson has issued a statement on behalf of the family members of Stephen, saying they are grieving privately and they are awaiting authentication of the video. And Janine, as you know, the mother of Stephen in this heartbreaking appeal a few days ago pleaded directly to Baghdadi, the head of ISIS, saying, please spare my son. And that seems to have fallen on deaf ears.
I also think they took a very firm decision that they were going to keep his being kidnapped quiet, unlike the Foley family, who had a very different tactic, both of them desperately trying to get their sons back home, neither one of them succeeding. And I think that the Sotloff family made a decision that they felt that if they were quiet, if it was a media blackout, they would have more control, perhaps, at negotiating or getting him back. I just think I cannot imagine the pain that they're going through now, and also the anger of it and the frustration and the just the monstrosity of it all. It's just horrible.